are here with Mr. Donald, and we are asking him, how does he feel about Bill C-21 and Canada's gun laws?
C-21, I don't agree with C-21 whatsoever, and the National Firearms Association certainly doesn't support Bill C-21. We're hoping to have that repealed sooner rather than later. The gun laws in Canada, right now, we are vetted every 24 hours. All firearms owners in Canada are vetted every 24 hours. Police agencies have access to check our backgrounds. We are the most vetted people probably in the world. We are the safest people in the world. But yet we are being the most oppressed when it comes to the ownership of our private firearms. That's not something that we take lightly, and it's something that we're hoping to change.
Now, where's the disconnect? Where is this coming from?
A lot of it, I find, is opportunistic. It comes from the unfortunate tragedies that the government tends to love to use as an opportunity to attack law-abiding citizens. Anytime anybody is injured or killed in this country is a tragedy. Doesn't matter what it is or what form or method of assault is used, but for some reason or other they just love to tote the gun part of it. And guns in the right hands are some of the safest things you can use. As a matter of fact, insurance for firearm owners, liability insurance is one of the cheapest ones that you can have. You can get $5 million coverage for $10 a year. I mean, obviously insurance companies aren't going to turn around and give you $5 million coverage for $10 a year if you're engaged in a dangerous sport. So, it's obviously a safe sport. Bad people do bad things. It's an unfortunate part of life. It's a fact of life, we have no control over that. I think personally the government should be putting more money into mental health issues. That's where the issue is. It's not the firearm. Anybody that's intent on killing is going to kill. It's unfortunate, but it's a fact of life. And whether you use a gun or whether you run them down in a car or whether you beat them to death, it's horrible. But mental health would stop a lot of it. And they're going to have to start investing in mental health and stop wasting money on this ridiculous gun laws that do nothing for public safety. It's absolutely nothing. Currently, right now, the handguns, they're looking to ban, and they ban 1,500 different variants of firearms with AR platforms and hunting and sporting rifles as well. None of that does anything to stop gang violence or get people off the streets that are mentally ill. None of it does. All it is virtue signaling by the government. And in our opinion, it's a total waste of taxpayers' money.
Awesome, beautiful. Thank you, Mr. Jones.
Thank you.
I appreciate it.